tell you, social media is amplifying the divide between black men and black women. Pages like Justin LA Boy, pages like Spiritual World, who take the most toxic messages from Twitter and all other platforms, put them in one space that are purposely perpetuating narratives that we really aren't interacting with in the real world. You go on a day, you're not having these conversations, but you go on social media and these conversations are constantly repeated, and none of it is solution focused. It's all what they do, what's not being done, and it's not productive. It's not pushing us forward. And what's happening is we are internalizing a lot of trauma that does not belong to us.
It's a war going on, people. And I'm not talking about in the Middle East. I'm not talking about in Israel. I'm not talking about America. I'm talking about Black America. And it's mainly going on social media. And this war is the Black gender wars. I know you guys have been seeing and getting inundated with all of these reels and, you know, videos where black women are trying to tell black men how they feel. Black women trying to tell black men how to behave, how to act, how to show up. It's videos out there where black men are trying to convey to black women how we actually feel. It's videos out there where black men are trying to tell black women how to live their lives. Now, I got a new series, and you guys see it right there, and it's going to be addressing all aspects of the black gender war. What is the black gender war, though? Where did it come from? Did it just pop up all of a sudden because people just started feeling these feelings? No. These feelings have been deep-rooted since we stepped out of that bondage of slavery. Today is Juneteenth, and it represents the last slaves that were, you know, in bondage and, you know, got set free back in the day. But we held on to a lot of those attributes and characteristics and behaviors of slavery that was bestowed on us way 400 years ago, you see? And we talk about this Willie Lynch. And if you guys don't know what Willie Lynch is, it's a letter where, you know, this fictitious character named Willie Lynch had basically had a doctrine on how to break a slave and make him or her do what the slave masters wanted him to do. See, in this literature, and that's what it is, it's not real, you know, but everything that's said in this Willie Lynch letter is actually factual on the lifestyle of slaves, on how slave masters used to actually break the slave, you see? Put the dark skin against the light skin, the old against the young, the woman against the man. And that right there is what this series is going to be delving into, from the woman's point of view, from the male's point of view, and trying to hone in on how we can correct this internal fighting that we have going on in our culture and community. I appreciate you guys coming to the video today. And if you're finding my channel for the very first time, I am Dutch the Creator, and this is Inside the Culture Podcast. Let's get started.
And women today, like the modern woman, they want the aesthetics of what a man is, but they actually don't want a man because they don't want to be submissive.
Y'all associate the role of who it is and eliminate the logic to it. We just want y'all to respect our position.
Because if you'd have came around a bunch of married people and a community that supports marriage, people would have told you, girl, you better go back home and work this out. And people would have told him, man, you better go on back home and fix this.
Right.
Versus get out here and live your best life.
every time he go with you somewhere. What's going on?
It's not a problem. It's not a problem at all. Hold on.
Come on.
It's not a problem. Every time he come with me and I chastise him about something, he want to get in his feelings and shoot you a text message. Okay. He want to go back home.
All right. But the thing is, you run your house like a boot camp. That's why your other kids ain't happy there.
No, he's not used to that. No, I run my house with structure and discipline.
These videos and these reels that I see on Instagram mostly, and it's very powerful. I mean, look, the things that these people say about the other gender is right spank on. You know, I mean, even from the women's point of view, when they're talking about what men need to do, how men need to show up, I agree with 90% of what they're saying. That's why this genre of speaking on the other gender is so popular right now, because they're not lying. But I think the through line here that we need to really address is who's right, who's wrong. And I believe both sides are right and both sides are sometimes wrong. And that's what we're going to be talking about, not only on this episode, but subsequent episodes. We're going to really be just talking about the genre as a whole right now. And I want you guys to go down in the comment section and let me know of your experiences. Is it really like that in real life, or we just see this on social media? We just see it play out on social media. Me personally, I do see it play out in my personal life with certain relationships I have with men and women. You see, so at the end of the day, this is a real thing. These are real topics that we need to tackle. I think the gender wars need to happen so we can build a better community and a better culture. See, the word culture comes into play here. Culture is when a lot of people from one group is doing a certain thing and it's, you know, just perpetuated. It's a cycle. It's what we're known for. It's what you're known for. The thing about it is, in the Black community, just like I pointed out in the intro of this video, we are damaged. We are traumatized from a lot of things that was bestowed upon us. And back in the, you know, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, we were fighting together against this thing. And then somewhere around 70s, 80s is where it just split apart, you know? Talk shows started to pop up, like Jesse Raphael and Donahue and all of these shows, Jenny Jones, Ricky Lake. And a lot of women started to go on these shows. These shows were catered towards the women who didn't feel that they were getting properly attended to by men. So they will go on these shows and speak on their grievances that they had with men, right? And they had that outlet. I mean, you guys can go on YouTube and pull up all of these videos where these women are going in on men. And it was, you know, a lot of men are drunks. A lot of men beat their women. A lot of men are gay. I mean, they were going in on men, especially Black women in those days, especially the early 90s. And they had a platform. But men, we didn't have a platform. None of these shows really catered to us, you know? So where did we voice our grievances at? We did it in the barber shop. We did it at the cookout in the corner. You see? That's how these things manifested. That's how these things came to be. Damn. We had something called social media show up around 2000 and I say 8-ish, you know, that's when social media first started to get its legs, and well into the 2010s, see? And we had one man, and his name was, or is, Tommy Sotomayor. He came on the scene on YouTube in 2012, I believe, and he had a show on Blog Talk Radio in 2009, and, you know, no one really was listening to him on that radio show. But like he said on a show one time, he said, hey, my producer had just posted a video of me giving my grievances about black women. And he posted it on YouTube. And he said it just blew up. It just blew up completely. And after that, a phenomenon happened. And it didn't happen very quick. It didn't happen like we see it today. What we see today is multiple men. I mean, a plethora of men on YouTube, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, giving their grievances. But these were the same men who were condemning Tommy Sotomayor, not specifically for lying on women. They were condemning him for talking about them in public like that. See, we got used to being in that barbershop. We got used to being off on the side of the cookout talking about these things. And we never wanted our women to hear this out loud in the public, you see? But Tommy Sotomayor was doing this, and a lot of black men got mad at him. And of course, a lot of black women got furious with him, you know? They never told him he's wrong, though. It was just a collective idea of, this is our culture. We keep it in-house, right? We don't air out our dirty laundry. And his reply will be, that's cool if y'all wasn't on them shows back in the day airing out our dirty laundry, live on Oprah, live on Phil Donahue, live on Ricky Lake, live on Jenny Jones, live on all of these shows. Ask your mothers, if you're young, what happened on those shows back in the day. But it became something to where he became the villain of YouTube. I mean, he can't even be on YouTube right now in 2024. Because he was so crass, he was so direct, he was mean at times, he cursed you out, he called you names, he called you out of your name. He spoke on the black community in such a harsh way to where people just did not want that man around. People did not just, they said get rid of Tommy Sotomayor. He had threats on his life, he had all of this happening to him. But something was birthed from the idea of Tommy Sotomayor. A lot of men started to acquiesce to what he was saying. I was one of them. I listened to Tommy Sotomayor back in the day. I rarely listen to him now because I think something other than what I used to think about him. But back then, I was honing in on it. The reason I'm on YouTube right now is because of that man. I seen him doing his thing. And in 2015, I decided to do my thing. But the thing is, something was birthed. It was a blueprint. We understood that we couldn't talk like Tommy Sotomayor, or we would get banned as well. You see? So something was birthed. Something really, really important was birthed. And that something came in the form of the late great Kevin Samuels. See, Kevin Samuels only had a 2-year run, but Kevin Samuels was on YouTube. He was in the crowd and audience of Tommy Sotomayor just like I was. But Kevin Samuels understood how to market what Tommy Sotomayor was doing on a mass public level to where it will get accepted, not fully accepted by women, because they were going on his show and he was tearing them down with logic, common sense, and reason, right? But it was a blueprint now. We have a blueprint for this where you don't have to cuss the woman out. You don't have to call her out her name. You don't even have to get loud with her. You just take everything Tommy Sotomayor was saying, filter it out, filter out all of the BS and the controversial parts, and then add something to it. And see, Kevin Samuels added a factor and an element to this argument about, you know, schooling our women on how to get a high valued man. And it was genius, man. It was genius. And everybody seen that first viral video of Kevin Samuels breaking that woman down, saying, "You will die alone." Everybody seen this. And that's when it sparked. And that was around 2018, 19. And then going into 2020, we had the pandemic. So everything got shut down, but a lot of cameras got shut on. You see, a lot of men started to take on the words of Kevin Samuel and make their own little renditions of it. You know, add their own little spice to it. And what we have today is a plethora of men, just like we had a plethora of women back in the early 90s on these shows, speaking facts about the other gender, about what they're going through, about how they feel. See, men never did this in public until now. And then the women, they jumped in on it. See, that first wave after Kevin Samuels, the men were doing it, and then the women came and said, "We got something to say as well." Now, this new generation of women, birthed from those women in the 90s, and a lot of them didn't have fathers. So they're online, they're talking, and they're telling men how they really feel. So it's a back and forth going on now. After Kevin Samuels, it started off as real feelings, right? Like real feelings. These people were really just getting on videos and, you know, speaking their piece on the other gender, right or wrong. But they were doing it, not getting monetized. But when people started getting monetized for this, that's when it became a business. You see, that's when it became an actual business. And I believe the third step in this was black women actually understanding that, hey, it's a business in this. And what I know of black women, they're going to make chicken salad out of chicken shit. My mother did it for years, baby. They understood how to get through those struggles, you know? So, and it's another side. It's another side as well. I think black women actually started to listen to black men, the ones who not doing it for, you know, monetary gain. I'm starting to see a lot of black men, black women have the talking points of black men. I don't know if you guys are, I don't know if your algorithm is, you know, showing you these videos of black women just, you know, going in on other black women on how men are getting treated.
So it's just like, women don't want to be submissive. Women don't want to be corrected. We're the only nation that of women that say they don't need a man. And you have all these other nations, those women aren't saying that.
Am I the only person that finds it very hard to admit to a man that I'm wrong? And arguing with men is the most annoying thing ever, because you men use logic. Like us women, we just want to argue with emotion, but you men, you use too much logic, too many facts. Like when you're arguing with a man, there is no emotion involved in their argument. It's just, you did A and B, which caused me to do C, and that's why we're at D. And I'm like, but, because of D. They don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear it.
If you do not feel compelled to cater to that man's needs, and I'm not being dramatic, if you don't feel the urge to make that man's life easier on a daily basis, stop playing with that man's time. You do know life is a lot more fun when you actually like your partner and like doing things for them, right?
And that's where we're at today in 2024, people. And if you're still with me, I appreciate you. I told y'all I gotta give you the root of all of these situations going on to give you a better understanding of what's going on. And I believe right now we're at a volatile moment in social media where we are just seeming like we hate each other. And that's where I got the idea to do this series. That's where I came up with an idea. And I said, you know, something has to give. Some type of understanding has to transpire for us to evolve into what I know we can be together. Like I said, it's women out here who are dead on target with what they're saying about black men. And it's black men out here who are dead on target of what they're saying about black women. And we're going to get into each side with the subsequent videos that's going to come on this series. But it's starting to get really ugly out there. It's starting to get to the point where it's affecting our personal lives. The economy right now is, rent is high, people are broke, and what we don't need is separation. What we don't need is to keep fighting amongst ourselves on these little issues like the Cheesecake Factory, going on dates, what a man should do, what a woman should do in certain situations. And it's affecting the relationships, the potential relationships of a lot of people out here. That these two people could have been great together, but she heard something on her algorithm that says the man need to be making six figures. And he heard something on his algorithm to where she needs to submit to him. And this man may not be making $100,000 and up. He'd probably be making $60,000, $70,000, but he's a great guy. This woman, she may not understand how to submit to a man, but she's a good woman. She just don't know how to. She literally don't know the definition of submitting to a man. So these two people will not get together based upon what they're seeing online, based upon these conversations, hard conversations, and I think much needed conversations. But we're taking it too far. We're taking it in our soul to where we were forego a good thing based upon what social media is saying about something in general. And that's where this series come in at. We're going to take a look at all, as much as possible, of these videos and reels and different perspectives. I'm going to have guests on sometime that's going to talk to me about these things. And we're going to delve right into it. I want you guys to go down in the comment section and speak your piece on it. What you have to say about each video. Each episode will feature one side of this argument. And at the end of each episode, we're going to come and try to give some solutions to what's being said and not just harp on being on the man's side or being on the woman's side. You see, it's a lot of things going on in our community and in our culture that we need to fix relationship wise, people. And I really believe that these conversations, which are healthy to have in general online, on social media, because a lot of youngins need it. They don't have it at home. They don't have it at school. They don't have it in the streets. So they can hear it from somewhere. But we gotta have something that we have to ourselves on our personal lives. We can't let that, the generalization, dictate our personal. If that person is nice to you, that person is genuine to you, that person is all about you, that person is pouring into you, that person cares about you, that person is really into you, don't forgo that just because your favorite podcaster said XYZ shouldn't be messed with, XYZ shouldn't have access to you. You see, you use these things as tools. You know, you use the information as tools. Apply it where it need to be applied to, but don't blanket it. Don't not go on a date with that man because he's taking you to the Cheesecake Factory. X that out your head. Matter of fact, use that time to talk about those situations with that man, to break that ice. You never know who's around the corner. You see what I'm saying? So that's what this series is going to be delving into, okay? Each episode, we're going to take something from social media on what the woman is saying or the man is saying, and we're going to unpack it, and we're going to try to find some solutions. Like I said, if you guys are finding my channel for the very first time, please make sure that you tap that like button so someone else can enjoy and find the content as well. And hit that subscribe button if you're really trying to delve into this series. And look at all of the episodes of Inside the Culture podcast. Some videos just popped up on your screen, and it goes a little more deep into outside of this new series. But I appreciate you guys coming through. Y'all be safe and stay unplugged from false narratives. I'm out. Catch you on the next episode.